नमस्कार। सो इन दिस सीरीज ऑफ बीएससी आईपीएफ वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस फाइनेंशियल स्टेबिलिटी रिपोर्ट विच द आरबीआई हैज पब्लिश्ड एज रिसेंटली एज जनवरी 2021। देयर इन दिस रिपोर्ट आरबीआई हैज कवर्ड इट्स अ एलैबोरेट रिपोर्ट विद 119 पेजेस। वी वोंट कवर ऑल द पेजेस, बट हाउ ग्लोबल एंड डोमेस्टिक इकोनॉमीज हैव रिस्पोंडेड टू द क्राइसिस, and because of that response of pumping liquidity, because of that response, now what are the repercussions that are happening? So this is a next part, that when the global and domestic economies are recovering, what are the challenges which RBI is facing, how it is trying to manage the inflation growth dynamics globally as well as locally, what is happening, all that is covered in this, and it will give you an insight of specifically the banking sector, because along the report many places RBI has categorically spoken about banks, banking sector, in some cases PSUs, in some cases stock prices of banks. So all that has been covered. So this will be a series of like 15 videos or something of 7 minutes, 5 minutes, depending upon the content. So this is the first video. Now before, so we'll start now. So before the crisis happened in January 2020, before the pandemic struck, when IMF, World Economic Outlook, IMF, so when the IMF asked for project, made some projections, they said that in 2021, the global growth would be around 3.4%. This was the projection which they had made. And in 2020, of course, the GDP growth was around 3.3%. Now, look what happened in April. In April, in 2020, the figure came minus 3.0. Why? Because pandemic had struck and lockdowns had begun. But everybody was expecting that the next year, the global growth would spring back because the lockdowns would have ceased and a vaccine would have come. There was euphoria about the vaccine in the projections, and that got reflected in this growth. Slowly in June and October, you can see again that this was always in minus because we were in lockdown, a global economy. But you see, from 5.8, this got to 5.4 and then 5.2. So the initial expectations about global growth jumping back to life got slightly tempered down, and that's what RBI says. Optimism about global growth on the back of vaccine rollout is now tempered by the realization that production and distribution constraints will allow only a gradual move towards vaccination, mass vaccination. So in India also, before on the 16th of Jan the vaccination started, before that twice dry runs were conducted to ensure that it happens all smoothly. How the cold storage will be arranged, how the logistics will be arranged, all of that needed to be streamlined, and therefore, just for one country which is diverse as vast as India, and then the whole globe. So this thing is not going to happen overnight, and those realizations started coming into the estimates or the projections, and that's why the expectations of a spring back to normalcy started coming down, and people were expecting that, okay, it will be only a gradual recovery. Now, interesting is 2019 in this particular chart, how will some of the countries of the globe grow in the next few years? So those projections are being made. This is by World Economic Outlook, and it is in October 2020 that IMF has published this. Now look at this. This gray bar is for 2021. The gray bar is for 2021. Now in 2021, all the countries which are expected to grow, India is expected to grow at 8.8%. Now this we have to keep in mind. This is not a local projection. This is from the IMF. That in this particular year 2021, all the major countries, states, Euro, UK, China, Brazil, Mexico, and India, Brazil is in a difficult situation, India is expected to grow at 8.8% real GDP growth, and that we have to keep in mind when we are looking at our economy or our stock markets and so on and so forth. So this is the first video in this longish series of 119 pages. Not all will be covered. In the next video, we will see that when all global banks, is including RBI, when they opened the tap, that means when liquidity was made available globally, because of that, what happened to interest rates and global economy and so on and so forth. That's going to be the second video of this series. So thank you very much for watching. It's an educational initiative by BSCIPF, roughly around 15 videos. This series will be in Hindi also and Marathi also. Thank you very much for watching.